听众朋友们大家好，欢迎收看老戴解说的《我欲成人》第十四集。故事紧接着视频的第十一集， Marcus 来到了耶利哥之后，发现缺乏很多的补给品，于是来到了魔控生命的仓库码头。
This is crazy. If they catch us, we're dead.
What do we do now?
We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me.
为了耶利哥可以更好的发展，或者说现有的人可以更好的生存，要到魔控生命这里来偷取更多的零件和蓝血。看门狗二即视感，或者说 GTA 码头即视感。
Don't let them see us.
Watch out.
有几个已是清白的。
Now what do we do?
I'll find another way.
Cyberlife warehouses. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me.
一台无人机要搞定它，否则无法行动。这边有好几条路，我们都先试试看。这边直接爬，太高了，跳不上去。然后直接奔着无人机去，太远了也没办法，所以说还是走正常的路。直接跳还是上不去，太高，要找旁边的垫脚。奔着无人机去，哎呀，还是太远。在这个地方我们可以故意不摁，然后诺斯会过来吐槽我们，并且跟诺斯的好感度下降。这边大量的蓝血，来了一个仿生人。
You were trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! God damn machine? Where is it this time?
这边有四种选择，我们把这个仿生人给拉进来。
John,
别动，别动，别动，快点。
I need your help.
John,
可以选择不动、放手或者攻击，我们选择放手。
There you are. What the hell are you doing?
I was inspecting the platform. Everything is in order.
Good. Then I'm going back to the control station. I'm soaked. Take the drone to maintenance and make a report.
Understood.
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough.
Marcus 跟其他仿生人不同，他有特殊能力，触碰其他仿生人的时候，可以让这些仿生人变成异常仿生人。喝完蓝血了，上面有个柜子，过去看看。崭新的仿生人。诺斯是所有的真人扮演者当中五官长得最立体的。
That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here. We can't bring them back with us. It's too dangerous.
They come with us.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
The trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control station. There are two human guards. We'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus.Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
It's a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky. Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone. It's not worth it for both of us to risk losing our lives.
这三个队友当中呢，乔许是相对来说比较保守派的，诺斯是那种激进派的， Simon 属于是比较中间的那种，决定权在我们手里。哎，里面有两只小茶。这里可以看到钥匙。正门没办法进，我们要想其他的办法。在这里边有三种方法可以获得钥匙，可以用枪进行威胁。 钥匙就在前边，我们只要在现在的位置，理论上他们是不会回头的。然后我们可以到这边窗户看，可以把警卫引诱到外边，以及引发停电。我们使用，哇，这都听不见，制造短路。他们会去检查那边的电路。我们从另外一个窗户出去。走喽，别看喽。
Did you get it? Nice.
A truckload. We stole a whole truckload.
We got bio components for everybody.
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come.But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over.What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free.
Yeah! 大功告成 ，Simon， 你下岗了。这边我们用五种方式来形容贪生嘴炮流。当来了人类之后，我们躲起来，啥事不干。
What the hell are you doing? I told you to wait for me.
There are four androids hiding behind these crates.
What are you waiting for? Hit the fucking alarm!
如果选择逃跑的情况下，也会触发同样的逃跑过程。
You are committing a class 3 event. This infraction is being reported to the police. Stay where you are.
这样只获得了蓝血，那些仿生人和车子里面的东西都没有获得。
We took what we could, but we had to run before we could fill our bags.
There won't be enough to save everyone.
We risked our lives, and for what?
菜鸡马。
Yes, we took a risk, and yes, we failed. But at least we tried.Of course, it would have been easier for us to sit around and wait for something to happen. Because in Jericho, you're free, right? Free to do what? To die in silence, praying that no human finds us? Free to hope that one day they'll let us be who we are? I don't want that kind of freedom. I'm not gonna beg for my right to smile.Or to love, or to stand tall. There's something inside me that knows I am more than what they say. That knows that I am alive. No one's gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. Whatever the humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we will take from them. Because we are people. We are alive.And from this moment, we are free.
活没干成，你还理直气壮的在这边打嘴炮、洗脑，你说你能干嘛？三个队友肯定想，事儿没干成，嘴炮打得不错。马德执掌。
Looks like it.
接下来是手残无情流，我们使用枪械进去之后。偷钥匙失败，触发逃跑。跑到门口之后，之前帮助过我们的新的那一个仿生人会被狗扑倒，有两种选择，一种。
If we go back, we'll be killed too.
是拯救他，一种是抛下他，让我保持不认识。这样就获得了足够现有人使用的零件和蓝血。
We have blue blood and bio components.
There will be enough for everyone.
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
在这儿是自我膨胀流，当这个新的仿生人被扑倒之后，我们救他。马库斯膨胀了，因为你救不了他。
How do you feel?
还受伤了。
What happened?
North went back to save you. We managed to get away before the humans arrived.
Okay, where's John?
He didn't make it.
We had to leave our bags. We didn't bring back much.
There won't be enough to save everyone.
白去一趟，啥都没拿到。 接下来是葱影瘸腿路。
Goddamn dogs! What the fuck are they barking at?
在这为什么说葱影瘸腿流啊？因为我们要把敌人引到外边去，因为这一个理论上是发现的人最少，最容易发现的是使用枪支，所以我们先聪明一下。
Fuck, what was that?
The drugs fell down.
Then, 拿到钥匙，但是这个时候 Marcus 腿瘸了，就是我给他的设定，他是腿瘸了，他没有办法再跳窗户，我们要走门口出去。被发现以后报警就没有办法再开车走了，然后逃跑，然后腿瘸了跑不动。
Marcus, what are you doing? Hurry up!
跑不动呀，你好小茶，叫茶么么哒。马德执照。
How do you feel?
What happened?
North went back to save you. We managed to get away before the humans arrived.
Hey, where's John?
He didn't make it.
这个结果是一样的，啥都没得到。
We had to leave our bags.
新的那个 John 又死掉了。
We didn't bring back much.
There won't be enough to save everyone.
John!
接下来就是杀人如麻流。杀人如麻在两种情况可以触发，一次。这个人类刚刚来的时候上来就把他给宰了，或者是我们先把仿生人 抱起来，就发现我们的那个仿生人，先把他给藏起来，以后也可以杀人。我们在这选择的就是人类刚来就把他给宰了。乔喜是绝对讨厌杀人的，就是那个大学老师，大学仿生人老师。接下来在这个里面选择半操作失误，就是不要全程，需要失误，有一定的失误。杀了三个，杀人肯定是降舆论的。然后接下来我们说出去的时候，就会发现门卫这儿俩死人，已经没人了。回去之后是可以获得所有的东西，但是在演讲完结之后。原画欣赏时间，这儿是 Marcus 处理无人机的地方。一行人在集装箱之间跳跃的画面。开始偷第一次刚刚开始偷蓝血的画面，这是魔控生命在运输这些零部件的画面，准备去偷钥匙。 门卫的房间内，魔控生命的运输车，魔控生命的工作人员。最左边应该是最早诺斯的人设，然后左起二三两个应该是 Simon 的，四五两个是乔许的，最右边的是 Marcus 的。魔控生命的工作人员或者说保安，左右是人类保安，中间是仿生人保安。魔控生命的运输箱，最右边的是装整人的，左边的这个大的方形的是装一些零部件或者说蓝血的包装袋。魔控生命出品，底特律，以及装卸车。
Because of the style of the game, you have so many different ways that the character can go. Every decision, it's what I call kind of choose your own adventure. Like every decision that the player makes, it's going to open up 40 more pages of material and experience that ties in, which means as a performer, you have to try to continue to make things feel real that the player might not ever see, but also that in performance, it's not always connected to a previous act. It's grueling, it's hard work.But it's a great team, and I enjoy doing it.
There's no hair and makeup, there's no wardrobe, so we move really fast, and we'll go through about 35 pages in a day. Working in TV or film, we'll probably do 6 pages a day. It's kind of acting boot camp.
流程图讲解，在没有分支的情况下，它是现在大家看到上面有一个全球百分比的这样的一个显示。这个是游戏啊，有时候可以获得网络数据，有时候无法获得，比较的蛋疼，网络特别不好。我这次就运气比较好，90%的人都是跟着诺斯走，9%的人跟着 Simon 走。在集装箱上面跑步的时候啊，有两条线路可以走。然后到了无人机这儿，就是马克思受伤。就是趴上无人机以后不做任何动作，马克思会受伤。马克思受伤以后，诺斯会进行吐槽我们，并且好感度下降。然后开始偷东西，偷东西发现，保全仿生人出现之后有四种方案，分别是攻击、攻击仿生人，然后带走仿生人，把仿生人带着躲起来，然后逃跑和躲藏。其中逃跑和躲藏所触发的结果是一样的，是往下走，直接跑到这边一行人，然后会出到就逃跑的时候啊，就报警了，然后跑到围栏边，然后返回耶利哥啊，就是这样，一行人逃跑失败啊，就获得了少量的东西。然后如果说接下来就触发了约翰成为了仿生人，只要把那个仿生人抓起来以后啊，躲起来以后啊，那个就这个保全仿生人的名字叫约翰 John。然后人类保全来了，有三种方案，分别是攻击，就是杀了仿生人，视频演示到了，然后放手，这个时候 John 已经被变成异常仿生人，所以不会出卖我们，以及留在原地。然后接下来人类警卫离开之后，就是我们没有杀他，人类警卫离开了之后，触发了。找到了货箱，75%的人选择解救仿生人，然后这个时候 John 要加入，我们选择同意，79%的都同意了。然后 John 提到了钥匙，我们要去拿钥匙，73%的人去拿了钥匙。进入控制室，72%的人去拿钥匙，2%的人在进入房间的时候啊直接失败。这一2%的人大多数都是为了完成全收集的。进去之后使用威胁的方式，就用枪械威胁的方式，有三种结果，就是杀死警察和启动报警。启动报警肯定是故意的，杀死警察也是要故意的，要不然不大会，就是怎么说呢，应该说杀死警察是比较难触发的，因为你的过程当中需要 QTE 半失败半不失败才可以。如果完全失败的情况下，直接就是警报会启动，我们直接逃跑，就无法把警察给杀掉。然后 成功避开了警察之后，可以偷到钥匙，如果没避开就是报警，然后跑到围栏，会触发 John 被追杀，以及或者是我们到围栏的时候啊，被受伤这个样子。接下来我们的视频里面就找到了钥匙，回到了卡车，大功告成，偷走所有东西，神不知鬼不觉。我们的方式就是神不知鬼不觉的，对的，是最好的一种方案。然后大伙带着所有67%的人是神不知鬼不觉，但也不一定，有的时候会被发现，就是避开警察，反正我们是神不知鬼不觉，所有东西全部带回去了。杀人也可以把满满的一车东西都带走，对。然后大伙满载着物品回走，但是没有偷到车，这个就是属于是我们当中被发现了，或者是搜完了东西以后啊，直接走，就是不要交，不要这个新的保安仿生人，就带着满袋物品回去，以及比较烂的一行人任务失败，就选择逃跑，或者是躲起来，躲起来以后那个仿生人会把我们给举报，以及偷钥匙被失败了以后去救约翰，然后马克思会受伤，以及马克思站得不动，都会触发一行人任务失败的这样的结局。本关卡结局不多，但是比较的烧脑，你要想清楚各种各样的方法才可以触发所有的内容。好吧，本集到此结束，感谢大家收看，我们下集再见吧。下一集伊甸园夜总会。